Well, it's quiet here now along Bayshore Boulevard, but earlier today it was a much different story. Crews beginning the cleanup process right now here along the road. And you can see nothing but beads, beer cans, and barricades, just some of what's left from this year's Gasparilla.
A sea of pirates along Bayshore Boulevard screaming for beaded treasure.
I love when they like throw out the beads and stuff, and that's like what I'm here for.
An experience many look forward to all year.
I like the energy. It brings so many different kind of cultures and walks of life together. And we are here to do the same thing. Have fun.
The chance to celebrate one of Tampa Bay's longest running traditions, dating back to 1904. More than a century later, it's now grown to be one of the nation's largest parades.
It is the excitement, the energy. You just feed off of it, and you just want to give it back. You want to give the excitement back. You've lived, like, you've thought about this day all year long, and you just want to, like, live it with everyone.
More than 100 floats taking part in Saturday's parade, including more than 50 distinct crews of pirates, putting in dozens of man hours to get their floats ready to go.
Best bead throwing tips.
Oh my gosh, put it on your wrist, on your arm, then put it in, ball it up, and then throw.
Many, of course, celebrating with a drink in hand. Police encouraging everyone to do so responsibly and inside the permitted areas. As we begin 2019 with another Gasparilla in the books.
People are like hugging each other and having a good old time, and everybody's just going about their business. So it's pretty good. It's fun.
For the most part, police say it was mostly peaceful. Reporting in Tampa, Jordan Bowen, Fox 13 News.